As homeschool moms, we spend a lot of time planning for those good days. We look at the perfect curriculum, the perfect lesson plans, the perfect routines, but how often do you plan for the bad homeschool days? You know the days I'm talking about, the ones where you're hitting your head against the wall, the kids just aren't getting it, maybe you need some mental health break, or you're just feeling tired and worn down. Regardless of the reason, you need a plan for those bad days. And I have a resource for you that's completely free that you can easily put together and implement to turn those bad days around. So let's get started. What are we gonna do? My name is Katie and welcome to Life in the Mundane. I am second generation homeschool mom of six beautiful kiddos. And on this channel, we talk all things resources. I love to share with you resources that are going to help you in your homeschooling and help encourage you in your biblical parenting and how you can utilize those to their fullest potential so that you can make the most of the little moments. What are we going to be creating today? We are going to be creating your own bad day box. We're going to make a box full of easy, zero prep educational activities that you can pull out on a bad day that will help turn it around. So let's look inside. All you need is a box of any kind. This particular one is just a file box that I got at a garage sale years ago, but you can grab any crate basket box that you want, but you really want a designated space for these items. So that is the only rule of a bad day box. What you put inside it is totally up to you, but two key things that I recommend pretty much everybody have in their bad day box is some chocolate and also these Bible memory cards. These are encouragement for weary homeschool moms. And really all it is just Bible verse cards that will help you go over different passages of scripture that can be encouraging for a weary homeschool mom. I find that these two things alone can help change the tone of our day. Because as moms, we are the ones that set the tone for our home. Our kids mimic what they see. And so if we can help our attitude have an adjustment, it'll oftentimes play back on them as well. So before I even dig into what's inside the box, I will grab these two things off the top, enjoy a special little treat for my body and a special little treat for my soul. You can actually get these cards as a printable on my website. I'm gonna drop the link down below in the description, and there's some other fun goodies I've got for you as well that you can print completely free. So be sure to grab those to make your bad day box. As you can see, we have lots of books because as a good homeschool family, we love books. There are lots of different variation of the kind of books I put in here, but I do try to make sure they're books my kids do not always have access to. So I buy them specially for this box. For instance, we have the Come Look With Me series. This is a series of art books that are based on different topics. So this one is based on children and art pictures having to do with children. You have your children look over the beautiful pictures in the book, and then you ask them a series of questions that they have up here on the next page. Then they end it with a paragraph giving you more information about the artist or about the painting itself. So it's a great way to sneak a little bit of art in. You can just do one or two pages at a time. So this will last you for quite a few times of pulling it out. But I will say these books can be a little bit expensive when buying new. So I like to buy off thrift books. So I will drop a link down below where you guys can snag that for a better deal. So we also love to throw in Usborne books. We love to grab these, and as soon as I get them in the mail, I'll stick them in this box so my kids don't even see them. We love the Lift the Flap books for older kids. We have currently in our box the engineering one and the World of Shakespeare. And essentially, if you have not seen these, I know you guys are used to Lift the Flap books for preschoolers and toddlers, but these are much more in depth. They have that Lift the Flap element, but lots of information. So the engineering one goes through all the different types of engineers that there are, and then each page layout goes over a specific engineer and the ways that engineering works into that specific job. Another Usborne favorite is the wipe clean books that we like to have in here. These are just dry erase books, and they have them on every topic you can imagine, from capital letters for those beginning readers, to beginning pen control for your preschoolers working on starting to make some of those lines and follow directions that will help them for the future for writing, to grammar and punctuation. We've got timetables and clocks and all sorts of fun goodies, ways that you can work on the skills that your kids are currently learning in their regular curriculum, but mixing it up by coming at it from a different angle. And I love the fact that they can all be wiped clean and you can reuse them over and over again. The Bad Day Box is also the perfect place for all of those fun little Dollar Tree educational toys you find, or Target Dollar Spot things you find. So you can get great educational games, snag those and put those inside of your box. We have ones that go over math skills or letter bingo. Doesn't matter what kind of game it is, if it's educational and it can fit in this box, I highly recommend adding it. You can add in things like audiobooks or educational DVDs. We love the Your Story Hour CDs. They have great audio dramas on different historical figures or times in history. And my kids love to learn the facts. I have shown you guys these physical fitness cards before. In my previous video, I shared you indoor PE activity ideas. You guys can check out that video up above or down in the description below. But there are a lot of fun ways you can mix up these different activity cards to work in both education and movement to get the wiggles out on those bad days. But what else do you put in your box? Well, you can again fill it with whatever you would like. But I also have a fun little guide for you guys that again, you can get for free by checking out the link down below. And this guide is going to give you additional ideas that are endless opportunities for education and learning. Some of the ideas in this guide are 10 podcasts for kids. These are all educational podcasts you can listen to with your kids. 10 educational games you can play on your Alexa device. 10 educational YouTube channels. I actually just did a video on this just last week, so you guys will wanna check that out. Or I will say on each of these pages, I have a QR code that will take you to my website and it'll share with you guys a little bit more about each of these resources. It'll give you links so you can directly go to those resources and not have to spend a lot of time searching. So that's another fun little addition to this guide. And then the last four pages are actually a fillable document. So I wanted you guys to be able to personalize this to yourself, to come up with ideas. I know it seems like you should be able to think of a lot of these things just on your own. You shouldn't need to write it down. But on those rough days, decision making is hard and it can be overwhelming to be a creative, fun mom. So take the time, do yourself a favor now, write down a list of ideas, and then on those bad days, you can pull it out and decide what you actually feel up to doing in the moment, depending on the situation. So you can make a list of mood boosters for mom. We already talked about how mom sets the tone. So if you are in a bad mood, can you put on some fun music? How about taking a shower, making sure you've eaten something for the day other than your chocolate? Next, you have an outside time sheet. You're gonna brainstorm ideas that you can get some movement in, that you can have fun outside, and if you can throw an educational twist on it, that would be even better. I do have a video just on educational outdoor activities, and all of those are free and easy to implement, so that can give you some ideas if you get stuck. Indoor movement activities, like I said, I have an indoor PE guide for you guys if you would like, but this is a really important critical thing. Whether you are in a cold weather area or not, there are going to be periods of time where you are stuck indoors and you are going to want something easy to do inside that you can implement and get the wiggles out without losing your mind. So make that list now so you don't have to worry about it later. And finally, you have field trip ideas. Now, these field trip ideas can be as specific or as general as you want. You could say things like going to the library or going to a park, but make sure that, again, they really don't have much of a cost to them and are easy to do. Something that is going to require a reservation, because most of the time you're not gonna know when your bad days are actually going to come. The key to all of this is to have fun. Enjoy this box and use it in a way that's gonna work for you and your family. You can customize this any way you want it, and it can work all the way from preschoolers all the way up to teens, depending on what you place inside the box. I would love to hear some of your ideas of what you would like to put in your bad day box down below. But let's answer a few of the frequently asked questions I get about the bad day box. Number one, how often should I be using it? Well, the answer is as often as you need to. Feel free to use this. It's a tool for you and it's here to help. So don't be afraid to use it. That being said, if you are using it every single week or every single day, I would recommend just stepping back, taking a second and evaluating why that is the case. Maybe it's that you're going through morning sickness or a family tragedy or a big life change. And if that's the case, that's totally fine. It may just be needed for this time. It can help keep your kids on task, give them educational activities without having to be in the regular book work. But if there isn't any extenuating circumstances and you find yourself dipping into it that often, you may want to consider if there are other things that need to change. Maybe attitude adjustments, curriculum changes, routine changes, things like that. Because we want to set you up for success and be able to still identify when there's a problem that needs to be adjusted. Question number two, how do you actually use it? Do you open it up and give it to your kids? Do you control it? And how often do you change out the material? So the answer is really simple. I pull it out when I need it, but I am the one in charge of it. I'm the only one that looks inside of it. It's kind of like my magic box. They don't understand or know why it's being pulled out. I do not call it a bad day box in front of them because I don't want to put that label on the day. So to them, it's just a random thing that mom does where she pulls out a box of fun every once in a while. I control how many things we pull out and we don't get through everything in one day. It just depends on if we need a little boost in our day or if we need to just make the whole day a bad day box. The idea here though is that because you're controlling it, you can control how often you go through things. I honestly rotate just as needed. If we've completely finished a book, I'll throw a new one in. But don't feel like you need to constantly rotate things in and out. Your kids can have repetition because the idea is they're not using this every day. Number three is, what else should I consider including? You show me educational resources, but is there anything else I should have in my bad day box? Well, again, totally up to you, but I do actually recommend putting in your box maybe the reasons why you homeschool, or Nina over at Everyday Blessings recommends making yourself a bad day letter and writing a letter to yourself on a good day for when you're going through a tough time, reminding you why you're doing what you're doing. What you don't want to include that is key to remember is anything that you aren't typically up for on a bad day. So maybe you're a really crafty mom and crafts help relax you. Pack that box full of crafts and fun. But for me, mess and crafts are definitely not what makes me feel better on a bad day. So I'm gonna stay away from the glue and the glitter on this one. We all know those bad days will happen, but now hopefully you can be a little better prepared for the days to come. I would love to hear your ideas of what you would include in your bad day box down below. Stick around, subscribe, and click the little bell notification to be notified when new videos come out. We'll talk to you guys later. Bye.